Hey everyone, George here. Welcome back to the channel, The Art of Water. About 3 weeks ago, we threw this tank together here because we had some problems with the old build on it, and I promised you an update. Today, that's what we're gonna do. So let's just get to it. Hey everyone, George here. Welcome back to the channel. So a couple weeks ago, we ended up putting this tank back together. We had some problems with the other one cracking. And we used the old substrate that was in here to do a quick cycle on it and got the fish back in here. And I kind of talked about giving you guys an update on what was going on. Well, so far, everything is really beautiful on this tank. We have had no problems whatsoever. Everything, as far as water parameters and the health of the plants, the fish, everything is going just as I thought it would. You know, a lot of people don't understand the concept of an immediate cycle. When you have a lot of fish tanks, and I have many, as you know if you follow my channel, when you have that many fish tanks and you have one that has had a problem but has been running for over a year, it's very easy to use that substrate that came with the old build and put it immediately in. And we did a video on this tank, the build of it, and the substrate, of course, cycled within 24 to 48 hours. I can't remember exactly how long it took. And we put the fish in about 3 days after everything looked good. I wanted to make sure we had a little buffer time in there to test the water again and make sure that all the water parameters were exactly the reading that I was getting originally. So yeah, everything's good on this. There has been a lot of questions coming in and on the comments. People have sent me personal messages and asked me about my tanks and some things about them that they want to know. And I just thought I would answer a few of those questions today. Most of these questions have come in on my Facebook page. It's a great place for us to interact. If you're not following me on Facebook, there is an attachment on my YouTube channel that will take you to my Facebook page, and you can interact with me there as well. Now, I do have a Instagram page as well. I just don't keep up on it as much as I would like to. As I've said before, this is my hobby. This is not something that I do for a living. So, yeah, trying to keep up with all of that stuff is a little bit daunting for me. And so anyway, needless to say, I'm not 100% on my Instagram page. And you can go look there if you want. There's not a whole lot of content there that's going to help you. But I wanted to get to some of these questions that have been being asked to me over the last couple of months. And I just thought this was a perfect time while we were talking about the update on this particular tank to sort of answer those questions. I'm going to answer them based on the people that have asked the questions, and I'm going to read the question to you, and then I am going to answer that question as best I can. So the first question comes from Mike Zielinski out of Salem, Oregon, and his question was, how do I keep my plants as green as I do without using CO2? Well, that's a great question, Mike. And the first knee-jerk reaction to that question would be that I've just been lucky. Well, that's not quite accurate, because a lot of my tanks when I started in the hobby were CO2. I had CO2 set up on just about every tank. And I just found that the CO2 was expensive, and it also was something that I was finding that the plants were really sort of outgrowing themselves. And I found that if I used the right water parameters, the right lighting, and the amount of fish didn't overstock the tanks and that sort of thing, and water changes. I'm big on water changes. I know there's some people out there that say that you don't even need to do water changes and that kind of thing. I call bunk on that. I don't believe that. I think that you really do have to put the time and the effort into doing water changes. So I continue to do that. And I've just been really, really good about figuring out the balance between light, substrate, water changes, stocking the tank with lots of different things that keep algae down naturally. Number one, planting your tanks heavily is going to keep algae away, and that's because the plants themselves compete with the same minerals and needs of the algae at the same time. So if you have a heavily planted tank, the plants are going to win out every time because they will get those nutrients. I fertilize about 3 times a week, just a small amount. I don't go crazy with the fertilizers either. It's not necessary. The substrate will typically give you what you need for the first year. And then after that, what I tend to do is use basically some tabs that are fertilizer tabs in the soil right around the main areas. You know, I hit around 5 spots in the tank, each tank that I have, and that seems to just take care of it. I don't think it's luck. I said that earlier, but I don't really think it's luck because it really is about the balance of everything in the tank, making sure that you have shrimp, that you have snails, and that you have algae eaters like Otto Cichlids or Siamese algae eaters. There's lots of different things that you can do to balance the tank out. So that's what I would say is the answer on that, Mike. And I don't want to waste a lot of time on it because there's other people that have other questions, and I want to make sure that I can get to everybody here. So the next question comes from a guy named Dave Walters, and he is out of Dallas, Texas area. Now the question that Dave has is, how do you build your tanks and come up with a design for them? Well, basically what I do is I follow what I've talked about on here before, the rule of thirds or the golden ratio, and that is the flow of the tank going in one direction or the other in the thirds that we've talked about before, and making sure that that flow absolutely is in the direction where that you have a heavier end, a nice center, and then a shorter side of the tank. This is the rule of thirds or the golden ratio. So that's kind of how I follow things. Now, how I choose hardscape and that kind of thing, that's just really a personal preference that everybody has. So has nothing to do with the design of the tank other than the fact that you're using certain materials that you personally like. For example, in this tank here, we're using maple stone, some spider wood, and of course, various plants and things like that in here that are going to come up with the design. But design is really a personal preference, but I always try to use the rule of thirds and the golden ratio. And if you do that, 99.9% of the time, you're going to come up with a really great design that you're going to be happy with. But again, like I said, it's personal preference. The next question comes from a guy by the name, I might butcher this one, Zandar Kalavoski, and he is actually out of Hungary. And his question is, how often do you do water changes? Well, like I said, water changes are really important to me. So having a question like that's really easy for me to answer because it's something that I'm really, really a big proponent on. And I believe in doing water changes based on about a quarter. Well, let's start over with that. When I have a new build, I do about a 50% water change every single day for the first 2 weeks. Now, I know that sounds crazy, but I really do because I don't want the system to not cycle correctly by having way too many organics in the tank. Now, if you're cycling your tank with substrate that's coming out of another tank that has been cycled, you can do an automatic cycle on that. I still recommend doing the 24 to 48 hours. But on tanks like that, even though I know that that tank is cycling really well or has cycled really well, my tendency is to do every single day a quarter water change for at least the first couple of weeks. And then I go back down to about a half of the tank's water change once a week. And then I do half or 50% once a week once the tank I know is established and doing well. Right now, we're getting to the point here where I'm doing about 50% water change on this once a week. And probably next week, because we've been running about 3 weeks now on this tank, I probably will jump up to that once a week water change of 50%. Water changes are really important. I just think that they are. And I think that if you can use water that is been sitting out, I always have about 10 pitchers of water going in a particular room in my house. And I also have some 5 gallon buckets going that I leave sitting out for my larger tanks. And I have found that when you're using some good products like Seachem's Prime, Seachem's Stability, and you have a good filtration system in your tank, you're really not gonna have any serious problems once the tank is cycled. But being patient, I think, is the most important thing that people just don't have the tendency to do. Everybody wants to get their fish in there. And I made that same mistake early on. I thought I could break the rules, and I found out that I was only kidding myself. And it's after you spend a whole ton of money on losing fish and having to redo tanks and all that kind of stuff that you say to, and you're spending a tremendous amount of time, that you say to yourself, you know, I'm going to do this the right way, the natural way. And it just becomes very evident to you that you're doing something wrong and something needs to change. So having said that, water changes are so important to me, and I think they should be to everyone that's in the hobby, because what you're really doing is you're giving the fish the opportunity to really acclimate themselves to a tank, number one, when you first start it, and then giving them clean water all the time. This filtration system only does so much. After a while, the water in that tank is going to be only as good as it's going to be. And you can go through a ton of filters, you can go through all kinds of stuff. To be honest with you, I change my filters about once every couple of months in my tanks. And sometimes I even reuse them. As far as sponges go and things like that, there's enough organic matter in here and good bacteria that I can take my sponges out on most of my filters, wash them out really good, and just reuse them. As far as the filters go, as long as there's nothing wrong with the actual fabric on the filter, I think you can run those under cold water and get as much of the organic matter that is collected in there out of there as you can. And you can actually repurpose the charcoal. Now, charcoal tends to break down, so I don't want anybody sending me messages, well, that doesn't work or whatever. I only do that once with a filter, but I can get twice as much out of a filter by doing that. But again, big on water changes, and I really hope that answers your question. So that's really about it for today. I'm not going to spend a lot more time on answering questions. The Q&A was just something I decided to do because I was doing an update on this tank, and I thought it was a perfect opportunity to do that. A couple of people are going to wonder, where'd the beard go? Well, really quick on that, my family didn't like it. I tried to grow a beard back in the 70s, and my hair was blonde, but my beard was about as red as it got, and it just looked horrible on me. But I thought, you know, I'm getting a little older. My hair is still blonde. I don't have gray hair. But for whatever reason, my beard was coming in a salt and pepper kind of look. And I thought, oh, you know, I'll give it a shot here. Oh, I'm just not a beard guy. I'm just not somebody that can pull off a beard. And I kind of think that the clean shaven look for me is best. And I think I'm going to stick with that. But having said that, yeah, the beard's gone. And I think the folks around my house, or I should say, even the ones that my children who don't live at home here, when they come and visit, I shaved it off last night and they were just really happy to see it go. So having said that, yeah, the beard is gone. We're not going to be experimenting with beards anytime soon again. But that's okay. It was just something I tried after Christmas and the New Year. Just thought I would see what it looked like, and it's definitely not a good look for me. So anyways, thank you everyone for spending some time with me on the update of this particular tank here. Hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, please leave comments. I love the comments. I like to, whether you leave them on my YouTube page or if you leave them on my Facebook page, it doesn't matter to me. It seems like people choose to use the Facebook page to ask the questions, either in PM or right on my page. So either way, it doesn't really matter to me. As long as I'm answering your questions, it doesn't matter to me. I would like to see the subscriptions come up a little bit. They have really exponentially come up. I'm nowhere near anyone who's, you know, doing this full time on YouTube and really good at it. I'm not at their level, and I'm hoping to get there at some point because we're getting better and better at making the videos and making good quality videos. I've learned a lot from people that I have either watched or talked to personally, and I want to thank a few people for that. Number one, George Farmer. And the second person would be Yuri out of Germany. The guy is amazing at answering questions. And I've really been happy that those people have been willing to spend some time explaining the ways in which to make these videos. Anyways, hit subscribe, hit like, leave comments, and that bell up there. Every time I have a new video, if you just tap that button up there for the bell, you'll get a notification every time a new video comes out, and I really appreciate it. Share the videos with your friends. There's a lot of people out there that are starting in the hobby and have questions, and there's a lot of content. There's several hundred videos that I've put out over the last couple of years, and many of the questions that they might be interested in are going to be answered there. Anyways, thanks for joining me today. Thanks for letting me talk to you and answer some of your questions. George here, and I appreciate every one of you so much, and we'll talk again soon. Thank you.